SolveYourTech.com, your source for how-to guides and tutorials.
Hi, I'm Matt from SolveYourTech. In this video, we're going to talk about 15 settings on your iPhone that you might want to change. If you find this guide helpful, then please consider subscribing and liking this channel. Now let's check out the settings. Some website cookies only apply to the site that you're currently visiting, but there are others that can track you across multiple sites. This is common with social media applications and advertisers. Fortunately, the Safari browser has an option that lets you turn off cross-site tracking. We're going to show you how to do that next. You can turn off cross-site tracking on an iPhone by opening the Settings app, scrolling down, and selecting the Safari option, then scrolling down and tapping the button to the right of Prevent Cross-Site Tracking to turn it on. One of the more interesting features on the iPhone is the back button. It's not set up to do anything by default, but it's found underneath the Apple logo, and you can configure it to do things like take a screenshot, open the camera, turn on the flashlight. It's really useful, so let's find out how we can set this up. You can configure the back tap setting on your iPhone by opening the Settings app, scrolling down and choosing Accessibility, selecting the Touch option in the Physical and Motor section, then scrolling to the bottom of this menu and choosing Back Tap. Now you can select either Double Tap or Triple Tap, depending on how you want to activate this feature, and then you can just choose from the available options there. The Back Tap feature will work if you have a case on, but it works a lot better if you don't. So once you've applied a Back Tap setting, then you just need to find the Apple logo on the back, and then you just need to double tap it, and whatever action you've applied to the back tap will occur. I have a flashlight set for mine, and then you can double tap again to turn it off. If you often run out of battery life before the end of the day, or if you've noticed the yellow battery icon on your top right corner of the screen, then you might be curious about the low power mode feature. This is a setting on the iPhone that will automatically adjust several settings so that you can get as much possible usage out of your remaining battery life. Let's find out how to turn this on and off. You can enable or disable low power mode on your iPhone by opening the Settings app, scrolling down and choosing the battery option, then tapping the button to the right of low power mode to turn it on. You'll see that the battery icon is yellow when low power mode is enabled, and it goes back to black or white when low power mode is disabled. Now you can also go back to the main settings menu and choose the Control Center option, then scroll down and tap the button to the left of low power mode to add it to this top section. So now you can open the Control Center by swiping down from the top right corner of the screen. Then you can tap the low power mode button there to toggle this setting on or off. If you have an iCloud Plus subscription, then there's a really handy feature where Safari can hide your IP address from known trackers. This is really helpful in protecting your privacy, but it's a setting that can be toggled on or off. We'll show you how to do that next. You can turn off Safari IP tracking by opening the Settings app, scrolling down and selecting the Safari option, then scrolling down, choosing Hide IP Address, then tapping the Trackers and Websites or Trackers Only option. If you've ever noticed your iPhone screen changing its brightness level automatically, then that's probably due to a feature called Auto Brightness. While this can be useful, you might prefer to handle the brightness of your screen manually. Let's find out where to change this setting. You can turn off Auto Brightness on an iPhone by opening the Settings app, choosing the Accessibility option, selecting Display and Text Size, then scrolling to the bottom of the menu and tapping the button to the right of Auto Brightness to turn it on or to turn it off. There's a lot of settings on your iPhone that deal with the iMessages and text messages that you send, but one of these settings deals specifically with the images. It's called Low Quality Image Mode, and while it can save you some data, it can also result in some blurry pictures. So let's find out where we can change that setting. You can turn the Low Quality Image Mode setting on or off by opening the Settings menu, scrolling down and selecting the Messages option, then scrolling all the way to the bottom of this menu and tapping the button to the right of low quality image mode. When it's on like it is right now, this means that it's going to be sending smaller image file sizes, which can be the ones that end up being blurry. If you turn off low quality image mode, then it's going to send full size images instead. If you use a lot of cellular data every month and you find that you're paying overage charges, a lot of that data might be due to things like background refreshes and app updates. There's a setting on your iPhone called low data mode that you can enable, which will prevent these actions from occurring. This can stop you from using so much data, and it can also help to save some money. So let's check it out. You can turn the low data mode setting on or off by opening the settings app, selecting the cellular option near the top of the menu, choosing cellular data options, selecting data mode, then tapping the low data mode option. As you can see from the description here, low data mode helps reduce cellular data usage by pausing automatic updates and background tasks. If you find that you aren't able to use data in the way that you want, you can always just come back here and choose either the standard or allow more data on 5G options. There are some settings on your iPhone that can mimic physical actions so that you can hear a sound when you perform something. But these sounds don't have to occur, and you can turn them off if you don't like them. One of these sounds is the lock sound that you hear when you lock and unlock your phone. So let's find out where we can change that. You can turn the lock sound on or off on an iPhone by opening the settings menu, selecting sounds and haptics, then scrolling down and tapping the button to the right of lock sound to turn it on or turn it off. You'll note that there's also a keyboard feedback button here. If you turn these settings on or off, it will affect whether or not you hear typing sounds when you're sending a text message or an email. If you've ever tried to type in all capital letters on your iPhone, then you might have done so by pressing the shift key, typing a letter, pressing the shift key, then going on and on until you are done. This can be a little tedious, so if it's something that you do a lot, you might want to enable the caps lock setting instead. You can enable caps lock on your iPhone by opening the settings app, scrolling down and choosing general, selecting the keyboard option, then scrolling down and tapping the button to the right of Enable Caps Lock. Now that this is turned on, you can open an app like Messages or Notes, and then you just need to double tap the Shift key, which is going to add a little line underneath the arrow, and then you'll be able to type in all capital letters. If you have AirPods or use CarPlay, then you might have noticed Siri reading you notifications like text messages or calendar alerts. This can be helpful, but it can also be kind of disruptive. So if it's a setting that you would like to change, then you can turn off something called Announce Notifications to do it. You can change the Announce Notifications setting on your iPhone by opening the Settings app, scrolling down and choosing the Notifications option, selecting Announce Notifications in the Siri section, and then you can either turn Announce Notifications on or turn it off. If you have Announce Notifications turned on, then you can also adjust whether or not those announcement notifications play when you're using headphones, or you can select CarPlay and adjust some settings there as well. If you have location services enabled on your iPhone, then your device is storing a lot of information about the places that you go. This can be useful when you want to set reminders or calendar alerts based off of the location, but you might not like the fact that it could be a privacy concern. So if you want to turn off the significant location setting on your iPhone, then you can do so with the following steps. You can change the setting for significant locations by opening the Settings app, scrolling down and choosing the Privacy and Security option, tapping Location Services at the top of the screen, then scrolling all the way down and selecting System Services. Then you just need to scroll down a little bit more and tap the Significant Locations button, and then you can tap the button to the right of Significant Locations to turn it off, and then tap Turn Off to confirm. Now you can also clear your history here by tapping this button, and then tapping Clear History again to confirm. The AirDrop feature on your iPhone is a really useful way to share files, but if it's turned off then you can't take advantage of it. So let's find out how we can enable AirDrop so that you can start sending and receiving files. You can change the AirDrop setting on your iPhone by opening the Settings app, scrolling down and choosing the General option, selecting AirDrop, and then choosing either Contacts Only or Everyone for 10 minutes. If you select Receiving Off, then you won't be able to receive files from other people. You can also change the AirDrop setting by swiping down from the top right corner of the screen to open the Control Center, tapping and holding on the Wi-Fi icon, and then you can tap the AirDrop button there, and you can select a setting from that menu as well. The iPhone gets a lot of iOS updates, and it's not always convenient to install them. Luckily, there's a way that you can set up your iPhone so that it installs those updates automatically. Let's find out where we can locate this setting. You can enable automatic iOS updates on your iPhone by opening the Settings app, scrolling down and selecting the General option, tapping Software Update, choosing Automatic Updates, and then turning on the Download iOS Updates and or the Install iOS Updates option. You can also choose to download and install security responses and system files as well. The apps on your iPhone need to be updated periodically. Whether these updates are adding new features or fixing problems, you might be installing them manually by opening the App Store, tapping your profile icon, then tapping the Update button next to an individual app. While this gives you control over which updates get installed and which don't, it can also be kind of tedious. Luckily, there's a setting that you can change which will allow these updates to install automatically. You can enable automatic app updates on your iPhone by opening the Settings app, scrolling down and selecting App Store, then tapping the button to the right of App Updates to turn it on. You can also adjust the settings under Cellular Data depending on whether or not you would like to use cellular data to perform these downloads. When you send an email from your iPhone, it might include the phrase "sent from my iPhone" at the end of that email. If you don't want to include that information, or if you would like it to say something else, then it's possible to adjust the email signature. You can change your email signature by opening the Settings app, scrolling down and choosing the Mail option, scrolling to the bottom of this menu and tapping the Signature button. Then you can edit whatever is inside this text field. If you don't want a signature at all, then you can just delete everything. If you have more than one email account on your device, then you could select the Per Account option and you could configure different email signatures for each of those accounts as well.
Make sure to like this video and subscribe to our channel to see more tech guides like this one. For additional information on this topic and to read the entire article, click the link in the description to visit solveyourtech.com.